नमस्कार दोस्तों, स्वागत है आप सभी का आपके फेवरेट चैनल इजी जीएसटी फॉर यू में। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस वन इम्पोर्टेंट केस स्टडी पर्टेनिंग टू द एरर्स इन जीएसटी रिफंड और इश्यूज इन जीएसटी रिफंड्स, एंड द टॉपिक इज इंटरप्ले ऑफ ड्रॉबैक्स एंड जीएसटी रिफंड। सो दिस इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक एक्चुअली, एंड फॉर दैट द केस स्टडी इज इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू ऑन द स्क्रीन। So, RST Limited is exporting goods under a letter of undertaking to Poland. RST Limited wants to claim the refund of accumulated ITC containing the followings. So, the list is given, the details are given. So, there are inputs, input services, and capital goods of all the three tax components, total amounting to about 42,50,000. So, discuss the eligibility of the refund amounts in following scenario: A, no drawback is availed by RST Limited. B, drawback in respect of duties rebated under custom are availed by RST Limited, which is popularly known as lower rate of drawback, and drawback in respect of central as well as customs both are availed by the RST Limited, which is popularly known as higher rate of drawback. So, if we have to discuss about drawback, one important point which we need to note is that drawbacks are usually for the benefits given to the exporters to promote the exports and keep the pricing at a competitive level in the markets. So this concept is very much relevant to understand the mathematics of GST refunds because there is a linking to it. The duties and taxes which are neutralized under the scheme of drawback through foreign trade policy are: one, customs and GST in respect of inputs, and two, GST in respect of input services. So based on this rationalization or neutralization happens based on some specific rates of drawback dependent on type of commodity and not necessarily linked to the actual taxes paid. So a person may choose not to pay tax, clear the goods under LUT, but still can claim the benefit of duty drawback, which is pertaining to the taxes of custom duty as well as central taxes. So if we have to bifurcate the drawback into two categories, on a broader level, it would be lower rate of drawback and higher rate of drawback. Lower rate would have a drawback of taxes on related to customs only, and higher rate drawback would include drawback of taxes of customs as well as central taxes. So if you go to the CGST Act Section 242, it defines drawbacks as drawback in relation to any goods manufactured in India and exported means the rebate of duty, tax, cess chargeable on any imported inputs or any domestic inputs or input services used in the manufacture of such goods. So consideration of capital goods is nowhere there, first of all. So it is basically related to inputs and input services. It may be in case of imported goods or imported or domestic good procured goods and services. So drawbacks are usually the benefits given to the exporter to promote the exports and keep it at a competitive level, as we discussed. But there is a restricting provision in Section 54(3) of the CGST Act, which says that the proviso starts like: provided also that no refund of input tax credit shall be allowed if the supplier of goods or services or both avails of drawback in respect of central taxes or claims refund of the integrated taxes paid on such supplies. So this means the refund of unutilized input tax credit is allowed in case of zero rated supplies, provided that refund of unutilized input tax credit will not be allowed if the supplier has availed drawback benefits. But there is a catch. A supplier availing drawback only with respect to basic custom duty under the Customs and Central Excise Duty Drawback Rules 2017 shall be eligible for the refund of unutilized ITC of GST under the said provisions, which is commonly known as rate of lower rate drawback. And in Circular 37 by 2018, dated 15th March 2018, Para 2.1, it further clarified that refund of eligible credit on account of state tax shall be available even if the supplier of goods or services or both has availed the drawback in respect of central tax and customs duty, which is known as higher rate of duty drawback. So also this has been confirmed by the circular number 125 by 2019, which says para 40, the third proviso to subrule subsection 3 of section 54 of CGST Act states that no refund of input tax credit shall be allowed in case where supplier of goods or services both avails drawback in respect of central tax. It is clarified that if a supplier avails drawback in respect of duties rebated under custom and central excise duty drawback rule 17, he shall be liable for refund of unutilized input tax credit of CSUI and compensation cess. It is also clarified that refund of eligible credit on account of state tax shall be eligible if supplier of goods, services or both has availed the drawback in respect of central tax. So if we see the example, I'll take you to the screen of example. The first question is that what is the ITC that is eligible to be claimed as refund if no drawback duty is availed? So that would be 37,50,000, because capital goods is anyway not allowed in case of accumulated ITC in case of exports. And in case of drawback in respect of duties rebated under customs are availed by the RST Limited, which is means he is opting for lower rate of drawback. In that case also the scenario would remain the same, because he will be still eligible to claim the central and state taxes, which is accumulated ITC in respect of inputs and input services. But in third scenario, that is drawback in respect of central are availed by RST Limited, means he goes for a higher rate of drawback, then probably his refund will be only restricted to SGST portion, that is 750 plus 2 lakh, that is 950,000, and he will not be eligible for central taxes or capital goods in any case, in manner. Similar stand was taken in the case of Amit Cotton Industries, Gujarat High Court writ petition, special civil application, and it has been ruled that claim of duty drawback is not a valid reason for unreasonably withholding of IGST refunds. So you cannot just withhold the IGST refund. Here the taxpayer was a cotton and ginning mill engaged in the business of procuring raw cotton from the farmers, processing it and sending it outside the India. Taxpayer had claimed a refund of IGST on exports. The facts are a little different, because in our case the goods are cleared under LUT, and here it is cleared under the payment of taxes option. But principally the decision is of equal importance to understand whether the drawback actually restricts the refund. The GST authorities had verbally informed that Amit Cotton Industry taxpayer that IGST would not be sanctioned, because taxpayer had claimed drawback at the rate of 1%. That 1% is a higher duty drawback rate in regards to the exported goods, as against 0.15%, which is the lower drawback rate. So as per the provisions of circular 37 by 2018, it will not be eligible. So authorities were of the opinion that considering the circulars of customs where exporters avail such option and provide a declaration while claiming the higher rate of drawback, it would not be justified allowing exporters to avail IGST refund after initially claiming the benefit of higher drawback. So as the exporter was in extreme pain of cash flows and need of GST refund amount, the balance drawback duty, that is 1% minus 0.15%, that is 85.85%, he paid back to the government along with interest, and technically it could be minimal amount compared to the amount of refund of accumulated ITC. So probably he has taken that decision, but as per the authorities, the refund of the differential duty drawback by the taxpayer is a unilateral act, and it is nowhere recognized in the law, and hence not eligible, he is still not eligible for the refund. But the Honorable High Court, considering Rule 96-4, where the CGST rule, the specific CGST rule, gives the scenario for withholding of refund, and this drawback scenario is not considered as a valid scenario under Rule 96-4 to withhold the refund, took the call that this is not a correct stand, which is taken by the authorities. Also, the circular cannot be said to have any legal force if it is contrary to the statutory rules, specifically this Rule 96. And hence, the GST authorities were directed by the Honorable High Court to immediately sanction the refund, and not only refund, but 7% simple interest, simple rate interest on the said refund from the date of shipping bill to the date of actual refund. So apparently, it is now clear that when no drawback duty, drawback benefit is claimed, in that case, so apparently, when no drawback claim is benefit is claimed, full refund should be eligible. When lower rate drawback is claimed, both central and state taxes refund, that means full refund is eligible. But when higher rate refund is, higher rate drawback is claimed, at that time, the eligibility is restricted to only state taxes, but the assessee, considering the beneficial stand to him, can choose to refund the higher rate, differential rate, and again claim GST refund from this side. So that was it from my side on this interplay of refund and drawbacks. Hope you like the video. If you do, please hit the like button and don't forget to share it with your friends. Thank you so much.